Check us out on Patreon, guys, where we give you our exclusive access to all of our videos, 186 videos and counting. We just updated it. That's why I know how many videos is on there.
Bangers, too, though. Bangers. You know, nothing too shabby. I mean, I don't know, like a Led Zeppelin marathon. We got Metallica on there, some Megadeth stuff. You know, I'm just saying. Just throwing that out there, man. So if you're interested, definitely check that out, guys. The link for that will be in the description.
What's up, guys? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man. George.
What's shaking, guys? How you living out there, man? Shout out to the free thinkers, man.
All right, man. So we throwing you a little curveball today, man. White Rabbit, Jefferson Airplane. I've never heard about this band before. Now, I know we've seen it in the comments, though.
I've seen a couple. Yeah. A couple of requests, but I'm going to keep it real.
But not a lot, right?
It hasn't been a lot.
But I heard that this song was on the, I think, the Matrix 4 trailer. Which is coming out, which okay. I hope is going to be fire, because I'm a big fan of the whole Matrix, whole trilogy. With the exception of a couple, but we don't want to need
so
to get
the whole thing.
Yeah, we don't need to get into all that. I like it, but that's a long conversation. But the bottom line, though,
Las Vegas movie review channel coming soon.
Yeah, okay.
People would love that, though. But you know,
but dude, I'm excited for obviously the movie coming out. But I heard that this song was in that movie, so. And this is a big song, man. This song, I think, came out, what, in 67? It says June 24th, 67.
Oh, this that old.
Yeah,
would have been psychedelic rock. They're a psychedelic rock band, acid rock. Yeah, that's crazy, though. Garage rock. But pretty much psychedelic rock is where their specialty is.
Their album cover looks psychedelic in a mug.
Oh, that is the epitome of psychedelic. So Jefferson Airplane, American rock band, they were based in San Francisco. They're one of the pioneering bands of psychedelic rock. Formed in 65. Looks like they were headliners at the Monterey Pop Festival in 67, Woodstock in 69. Let's skip down here. Their 1967 breakout album, Surrealistic Pillow, ranks on the short list of the most significant recordings of the Summer of Love. Two songs from that album, Somebody to Love and White Rabbit, are among Rolling Stone's 500 greatest songs of all time. So, I'm guessing this could be a good song to pick, right? I mean, it's rated as one of the best songs. Looks like it was a breakout song, so.
Is that song Somebody to Love? You need somebody to love. Is that them?
I like that song.
I like that song, too, but I didn't know who sang that, so.
Okay, we might just cut to that song if we don't like this. Yeah. Because I like that song. It's been a while since we've touched the 60s. I mean, we go old school, but the 60s is old school.
Yeah, that's old.
So let's get into it, man. Jefferson Airplane, White Rabbit.
Bass. I like that bass, yeah.
Sounds like the Doors to me.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so far so good.
Guitar sound is sexy.
One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small. And the ones that
interesting man.
Mother gives you. Yeah, I think that's why they picked that for the making. One pill makes you larger.
That was interesting. When she came in, one pill.
Yeah.
Makes you larger. One pill makes you smaller. No, all jokes aside, though, like, it's interesting that lyrically, they were talking about they're using pills as a reference. One pill makes you larger, one pill makes you small.
So. Which is probably why they picked the song.
Yeah, the Matrix to move the franchise picked the song, yeah. All right, let's start that back up, though. She just...
One.
She sounds like Sidney Poitier, the way he speaks and shit. I am the black
guy. Maybe that was a thing, though, back then.
Yeah, you know, Sidney Poitier. Toastmasters,
but the bassist and the guitarist, that shit sounds beautiful.
I love the way that sounds like something that'd be on Kill Bill to me.
Yeah,
something
but
like that.
But beautiful though.
Yes,
Kill Bill's not a beautiful
movie. the soundtrack.
Yeah.
Again, like Las Vegas movie review coming, man. You know, we gonna start a separate channel for movie reviews. We gonna get it in, man. You know, let's start that back up. And the Doors is what I'm hearing.
Yeah.
Sounds like the Doors.
Yeah.
That's kind of around this time anyway. That psychedelic stuff.
Yeah, beautiful. Yeah. And it's soft too, boy. Like whispering to a girl's ear. partnership. That's all I think about now.
And one pill makes you small. And the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice when she's 10 feet tall. And if you go chasing rabbits and you know you
White Rabbit
and
Matrix as well, too?
I think so.
Chase the White Rabbit or follow Rabbit.
Oh, so this is a Alice in Wonderland reference as well, right?
Is it? I don't know.
Is she referencing Alice in Wonderland as well when you go chasing rabbits down the, what did she say? If you go chasing rabbits and you're going to fall, I'm reading ahead, it looks like, tell a hookah smoking caterpillar. Yeah, this is Alice in Wonderland as well. Has given you the call. Call Alice. So we'll kind of let the lyrics ride out a little bit. Kind of, now that I have that in mind, you know what I mean? And I'm sure that there's a metaphor in here somewhere. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's looked at as one of the greatest songs of all time. So I'm sure there's layers to it.
I didn't know that though. Because I've never seen Alice in Wonderland. So I didn't know that.
Yeah. Never seen Alice in Wonderland.
Nah, man. I know I had a deprived child. I didn't see that. But that begs the question now, maybe all the Matrix movies, especially the first one, like, I think there was a White Rabbit reference in there as well. So maybe they were referencing Alice in Wonderland as well.
Well, Matrix is all about the awakening, right? You're kind of caught up in the Matrix, and then you have this awakening. You take this pill, and you awaken, right? And Alice in Wonderland is, you know, it's about her finding her way to adulthood and all this other stuff, right? There's a deeper meaning within that movie. Right. It's this sort of awakening that, you know, this is a new reality now, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You go down a rabbit hole and you realize that things, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
So things are changing now with this. Your mind has now been open to a different reality. You know what I'm saying? Or reality. You know what I mean? So
I can see. You've been living in non-reality.
Right. So I can see the sort of correlation that the Matrix, you know, fucking soundtrack team. Or if the writers of the Matrix, I can see if there is a correlation, I can see the correlation there.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Let's get back to it.
Interesting song, man.
For sure. That was unique.
Very unique. Well, interesting song, George. probably not a song that is going to go on my playlist, but I will say the lyricism is interesting. I do see the correlation, though, between the pill references and Matrix and chasing rabbits. I've never seen Alice in Wonderland, so I can't really speak from that perspective. So maybe there's a lot of depth in the lyricism that I'm just not getting because I haven't seen that movie and I don't know what they're referencing. But it sounds like somebody's high writing this. That's what it sounds like to me. It sounds like, somebody was doing some hella drugs on this. You know what I'm saying? That's what it sounds like.
But psychedelic,
probably,
man.
I'm just missing it, though.
This
I'm
is the mid-60s. This is going into the 70s on some psychedelic shit. Yeah, so. Like,
you know what we could do, man?
Yeah.
We could make a song about rabbits in Alice in Wonderland, and that shit will be fire, dog. You know that? I bet you that's how that shit went.
Rabbits.
Yeah. Yeah, so, man, it's just... Yeah, not for me, but I don't know, man. You've seen what Alice in Wonderland, right? So give me your interpretation.
Yeah. Of what you're it's been a while, though, man. You know, I haven't seen that movie in so long. I'm just looking at the lyrics, man. As you were talking, I was still trying to get my head around the lyrics because I feel like it's clearly up for interpretation. I'm sure there's a billion different. This is clearly a classic song, mm-hmm. and Rolling Stone and a lot of magazines. As you were also talking, I was kind of looking up some stuff. And a lot of it's just a very, very seems like a very important song, mm-hmm. you know, for the time and just for music history. So I know it's a lot more than meets the eye. But when I'm looking at the lyrics, just off of this is just the first listen, so I'm not gonna be able to do the lyrics justice off of first listen. There's no way. But off of first listen, man, when I'm thinking of Alice in Wonderland, it says one pill makes you larger, one pill makes you small, and the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. I look at lyrics like that, and then it says. And if you go chasing rabbits and you know you're going to fall, tell them Hookah Smoking Caterpillar has given you the call. Call Alice when she was just small. Then I'll skip down again and it says, when logic and proportion have fallen sloppy dead and the white knight is talking backwards. And it ends by her screaming, feed your head, right? And from what I understand about the movie Alice in Chains, man. And
Alice in Wonderland.
When she says feed your head, the way I'm taking that is don't lose your purity, don't lose your imagination. It says when logic and proportion have fallen sloppy dead, and sort of this sort of confined space when you grow up and you become an adult, you start to have to abide by certain rules and structures, and the logic that goes into those rules and structures starts to falter in some to some degree. Call Alice to me is just always be in search of creativity, always be in search of open-mindedness. And it's how I'm taking it, man. That could be way off, and
that's
just the way I see it over first listen. Because I'm trying, because she's making all these references when the men on the chessboard. Because you know, there's the Red Queen off with the head, and I don't know when she says the Red Queen. Maybe it's in reference to dictatorships and stuff like that. And again, government dictatorships and stuff like that. So it just seems like.
Yeah, but I hear you though, man. Go ahead.
Oh, this is the first listen. This is really how our talks go, man.
When we talk about
music off the channel, we're just like, maybe that.
You know,
especially the line up there when she says, "In the ones that your mother gives you, the pill that makes you small, and the ones that your mother gives you don't do anything at all." It's almost like the advice that's handed down to you from your mother.
It's not good advice. It's just trying to comfort you.
Yeah.
Instead
of giving you the truth. Yeah. You know what I mean? And also maybe it just stifles your creativity. It stifles your open-mindedness, yeah. right? Your ability to dream and all these other things. Because your mother's telling you, no, take this. Mm-hmm. Take this and, you know, go to college. Do this. Stay in this particular mm-hmm. structure for you to win and do, you know, and survive in this life. But it also stifles you, right? It's sort of a dream killer to you, right? So, because Alice was trying to, you know, she was coming to that realization. Anyways.
I didn't know. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's deeper than what I think. Maybe I need to revisit the shit.
Yeah, I need to revisit the shit.
You know what I'm saying? I've never seen that movie, and I need to visit Alice in Wonderland, and I need to revisit.
Love that movie,
Matrix,
by the way.
Maybe, you know, mm-hmm. because maybe there's some subliminal messages that correlate with Alice in Wonderland as well. So, I don't know.
So, musically, though. I really enjoyed the beginning of this, man. I love the way that they set the stage with these sort of, psychedelic, guitar riffs.
Yeah, and, I hear you.
The bass in this, when it really started off, I think it just created this sort of dreamlike...
fantasy world.
70s dreamlike, though. You know, like I'm fucking just floating with colors and shit all around me. It felt very psychedelic. Yeah, that's the bottom line, because that's what it is. This is one of those times, Ryan, that I'm going to have to agree with what you say in terms of the production. It is just so old and dated in terms of the what they were able to do with the mixing of this, that it's just very difficult because it's so old to get into. You know what I'm saying? For me, it is very old. Now, her voice, I think her voice is very unique, you know, even by any era still. You know what I mean? In 2021, that is still very, very unique to me. So I think that sort of, it was innovation in the way she approached this. Now, whether or not I like the way it sounds is whatever, but I do appreciate the innovation in sort of her. It's almost like she almost sounded like a queen to me. She almost sounded like it's a very firm feeling to her voice, you know? Mm-hmm. And magic, and march the troops into the open sea. Yeah. Like, whatever. So I don't know if I enjoyed the way that sounded, but I did appreciate, you know, the innovation, man. So the lyricism in this song, Shine, by far the most to me. So not playlist, but I will be looking into those lyrics after this video, guys. And that's it. Shout out to Jefferson Airplane. I don't know if this is what we should be expecting with them or if they have something else.
What was the other song that
Someone to Love? You want to listen to that?
If that's it, if that's what we're thinking it is, that probably be more of my style. To love. Need somebody to love. Won't you? I think that is. Sounds like the same person.
I hope
person.
That's it. Please be
Oh, maybe
that
isn't.
No, I got John B.
Oh, yeah.
John B. and them.
And Babyface.
Oh, that's the shit, though. That song?
Someone to love.
Oh, yeah, that was the shit. Yeah, I forgot all about that. Yeah, I forgot all about that.
That song.
That's going back on the playlist. Yeah, I forgot all about that song. Forgot all that. Yeah. That's, I'm definitely.
I had to bring you back home.
Yeah, I'm about to listen to that
I had to bring you back home with that one. Let's check out Jefferson Airplane, Somebody to Love, man. Because I hope it's that what Ryan has been saying.
When the truth is found to be.
It's definitely the song. I can hear it all the way there.
No joy within you.
That for a second. See, you hear the difference in her voice, though. Mm-hmm. To me, I much prefer that sound. Even though I can tell that that's the same person. What's her name? Grace Slick.
Ooh, I like that name. Grace Slick. Shout out to the legendary Grace Slick.
But when I hear White Rabbit, you said she sounded militant.
Firm,
militant. Like, you know, hut. To me, I hear a little bit of that, but more so I hear scared. I hear like, I'm not going to. I'm just going to sing the song just like this. And in this one, she was like, hey, I need somebody to love. She was free with it. Because I feel like when the checks started coming in, and you know what I'm saying? And they got that, this is the breakout album, right? They're like, oh, okay, I can really get into this. But I felt like the directive from them, from the band, was like, don't fuck this shit up. This is our first fucking, you know what I'm saying? Sing it just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do not deviate from that. That's how I feel what happened. And then Somebody to Love came in and like, oh, okay, we getting paid now. We can.
Yo, that is so hilarious.
You know what I'm saying? That's the way it sounded to me.
I didn't gather that, but that's a very interesting take, sir. I feel like the first one was very purposeful because it almost felt like a marching. The groove was very sort of march-like with the drums.
Yeah,
and
I hear you.
So it felt like a marching firm delivery was this is what it called for, at least. So I can understand it. This one, I just think the music is just more upbeat. It just feels more upbeat and lively. And this is a different purpose, you know what I mean? And then, and then the chorus is just plain flat out catchy.
Yeah, it is.
Don't you want somebody to love?
That's just catchy. That's out of here. You
but know she what was saying? Singing though. She wasn't even singing in the other one.
Yeah, that too. I mean, it calls for more demand melody wise. That's for sure.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So, anyways, man, that's funny. Yo, if y'all want us to do that one though, somebody to love. You know, let us know, man, because that one. You know, we heard that part, but we haven't heard the full song. So I don't know if Ryan is, but I'm open to doing that reaction. So that was an interesting reaction. Yeah. I don't know what to make of that reaction.
You can't say that we don't go out on limbs and we don't try, man.
We try.
You know what I'm saying? We try to be a divergence out here.
We try, man.
Free thinkers, baby.
There we go. All right, so that's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you have subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. And also, guys, you know, join our Instagram, man. We're actually going to be partaking in voting. That's pretty much where you can put your request in. And we're going to be keeping track of votes and things like that on there. So join our Instagram. That information, of course, is in the description as well. I'm George. That's Ryan, Lost to Vegas.
We out.
We out.